Kerli and I'm from a small town in Estonia called Elva. When you listen to my first album, Love is Dead, there is actually almost half of it is electronic. But I guess it wasn't like fast electronic. My first single off that last album, Walk in an Air, is actually an electronic track. And there's other electronic stuff on it. And like about 3 years ago, I don't know, it was just kind of in the air. And dance music in Europe, where I grew up, is like, it's always been around. And when I was little, dance music was really popular. So to me, it was not like a new thing. It was just something that is actually really funny to see get so popular in America. I don't know, just things happened. Tidy reached out to me and turns out that my friends are huge fans of Tidy, and I had never heard his music before, so I checked it out and fell in love because his music is so emotional. And working with Switch was super fun. He just doesn't care about anything else than making music. We were in his house writing with him and his brother and just having tons of fun. And 78, the young Swedish producers that I actually found, randomly found because I just was doing writing sessions all over the world, and I had done sessions for 2 months, and I went in and we just clicked and it was magical. So these kids, the world needs to watch out for, because these kids are the most talented producers I've ever worked with. Actually, you know, I have a studio in my house, and like most of the time that I have off, I'm just in my house in pajamas. So that's a part of me. And the other part of me is the complete extreme opposite. I love to create these worlds. When you look at my music videos, I hand make pretty much like everything that you can see in them. And the more fantastical outfits I definitely make, because a lot of the times I can't even find what I'm looking for, so I'm just sketching things and just building them from scratch. And I don't know where the visions come from, but just they're just kind of in the air. I get a ton of stuff on eBay, so when I'm preparing for a video, it's not for me. It's not like somebody else writes the treatment and I show up on the set and just get filmed. I'm actually usually prepping like a month before. I'm hand making all these things, and I always have some pearls coming from Taiwan, and you know, my Velcro or interesting color zipper that I can't find in America is like coming from China. So it's always actually a lot of stress because everything takes like 3 weeks. So yeah, I shop a lot online. I don't even really shop in stores ever. Oh, so but the headdress isn't—it's not like a staple thing.
Right.
It's just for. Actually, what is more interesting is the shoes that I just made. They're sound sensitive. So, but they need a little Yeah. So these ones I'm the most excited about right now. Need a little tweak still, and today is the first time I'm wearing them at a performance. So. Yeah, I actually cook a lot. I actually cook a lot of Russian food. In Estonia, so the culture's been, we've been under so many different occupations that like the food is just, I'm not even sure like what the real Estonian food is, like meat and potatoes. But we have a lot of influences from German cuisine, which is meat and potatoes. And we have a lot of influences from Russian cuisine, so I cook a lot of like pelmeni and selyanka. I can make really good selyanka. I can make borscht. I make, I don't know, just Russian food, and we eat everything with sour cream. A dream dinner party would be Albert Einstein, Jesus, Cole Porter, Oscar Wilde, and RuPaul. Yeah, I'm super, super active on social media, so the best way to be in touch with me is on Facebook, because I'm always on my Facebook. I'm reading, I'm commenting back. Yeah, obviously Twitter, Kerli Music, K-E-R-L-I Music, Facebook.com/K-E-R-L-I. I'm also a blogger on Buzznet, so check out my blog on Buzznet, and I don't know, stay tuned for crazy stuff. Hey, I'm Kerli, and you're watching Ultra TV.